Welcome! In this tutorial, I'm going to show how to construct a cumulative frequency graph or an Ogive using the data analysis add-in in Excel. First, I've predetermined my upper limits or bin ranges here. To begin, click the Data tab and you should see the Data Analysis command on the right here. If it's not there, please see description on how to install it. Click the Data Analysis command, select Histogram, and click OK. For the input range, select the given data. And for the bin range, select the upper limits for the classes. Check labels, check cumulative percentage, and check chart output. Click OK. Now I'm just going to extend this and make it look more visible here. Next, I'm going to click on the legend here and hit the delete button. Next, click on any of the blue bars and delete. Next, we need to get rid of the more since we don't have any value above 50. So right click on the number 9 here and delete. Since this is not a histogram, I'm going to click the histogram and then double click and change the title to Ogive. I'm also going to change frequency here to cumulative frequency percent. Now I want the highest percent value here to be 100 and not 120%. So I'm going to right click on the vertical axis here and click format axis. I'm going to change the maximum value here to 1 instead of 1.2 and enter. Now I like the curve to start from the horizontal axis, showing where cumulative frequency is 0. That is the upper limit before 20, which is 15. To do so, I'm going to right click on row number 3 here, the second upper limit, and insert. Next, I'm going to copy the value in the first row to the second row. Next, I'm going to change the first upper limit to 15, which is the upper limit before 20, change its frequency to 0, and its cumulative frequency also to 0, and enter. And that's a good looking Ogive. Now, if I want labels on the curve, I can click on the chart and then click on the plus button on the right here, and then click Data Labels. And now from the graph, we can see that 62% of the data values are less than or equal to 35. We can also estimate that about 50% of the data values are less than or equal to 32.5. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.